Welcome. We are broadcasting live from the mothership. You are tuned in and listening to Starseed Energy Radio with your host Jonah Bolt. Starseed Energy Radio, where you can always tune in to hear the colors and see the music. Starseed Energy Radio goes live in 3, 2, 1.
All right, what's up, Spaceship Earth? Thanks for tuning in. You are now receiving a live transmission from Starseed Radio, where you can always tune in to hear the colors and see the music. I'm your host, Jonah Bolt, this Octurian Starseed. Today is Wednesday, August 19th, 2015. We are sorry about the live transmission yesterday, but the power lines were being worked on and we had no power. With that, we have an amazing guest who's coming back on the show who will just join us after the daily download, Mr. Phillip E. Collins from the Angel News Network. We'll be talking to Phillip the first half. In the second half, we're going to have an exciting live channeling on air. With that, I want to just mention Angel News Network is also run by Mr. Phillip Collins' two good friends, and they have been at it for a very long time. So if you have a chance in the meantime, check out angelnewsnetwork.com. Read about some of the amazing channelings and information that Phillip and his two friends are bringing forth to the planet today. Also, if you get a chance, we always say check out starseedradio.com for the latest news and updates. We always have Ryan Matthew Dernick posting on there. We have his Twitter feed as well as my feed. We're always posting up new articles, things to be aware of. And we also have our new live trackers on there tracking space weather and other things like that, earthquakes and volcanoes around the world. With that, I'm going to start the show with our daily quote. And the daily quote goes a little something like this. Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. Hatred paralyzes life. Love releases it. Hatred confuses life. Love harmonizes it. Hatred darkens life. Love illuminates it. From our very own Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. I'll post that quote up also on our page so you can see a picture of Dr. Martin Luther and also the quote. With that, we're going to begin the daily download. Joining us on the show is Ryan Matthew Dernick. Good morning, Ryan. How are you today?
Very well, Jenna. How are you doing today?
Doing good. Good to be back on the air without power yesterday. It was quite hot, but that's how things are. We are broadcasting live from Capos in Costa Rica. And those of you who know Capos, it is very hot here. So we're glad to have the fans back on running. So with that, let's start the daily download. Ryan, what's happening on Mother Gaia today?
Mother Gaia is always ever-changing and active. Solar activity is slim to nil still, and on to earthquake activity. The most notable earthquakes were about seven. I'm not going to cover all of them, of course, because there's so many earthquakes around the world every day. 4.6 magnitude earthquake was 172 kilometers east-southeast of Hachijojima, Japan, a 4.8. Shout out to your dad, 112 kilometers north of Roadtown, British Virgin Islands, a 4.5, 19 kilometers east-southeast of Lukogo, China, a 4.7, 83 kilometers west of Melobo, Indonesia, a 4.9, 115 kilometers west-northwest of Polis, Cyprus, a 5.8 near Kepulauan Barat Daya, Indonesia, and a 4.7, 78 kilometers south-southeast of Katsura, Japan. In regards to other news, as we've been covering and talking about in regards to the potential of a large and dangerous earthquake that could occur upon the Pacific Northwest, now just came out in the LA Times this morning, greater tsunami risk from Southern California quake study finds. The California coast could pose a greater tsunami threat to Ventura area than previously understood, according to a new study published Tuesday by University of California Riverside and U.S. Geological Survey scientists. So that's something that we have to realize. The tsunami wave heights could approach as high as 20 feet in a substantial earthquake offshore in the Ventura Harbor and Channel Islands beach area near Oxnard. So that's something to keep in mind as Earth is constantly changing. And in regards to other news in volcanic activity, they're monitoring the ever-growing possibility of a larger eruption in Ecuador at Cotopaxi volcano, as about 325,000 live in its shadow. It's been erupting on and off in small amounts, but increasing in fervor since Friday. And on Saturday, it shot ash more than 2 miles high, which spilled some lava. and 400 people were evacuated briefly at that time. Now, the last major eruption there was in 1877, so roughly about 140 so years ago, and ashes already reached the capital of Ecuador in Quito. So that's something that we have to keep in mind in regards to the situation over there. And, of course, Sakajima volcano in Japan. Now the alert level is raised to 4 at very high, and over 100,000 people are in jeopardy of having to being evacuated in that area. And as well as in regards to what we've been talking about, they reactivated the nuclear reactor near there, about 30 miles away, the Sendai nuclear power plant. The president and other people think it's fine. We could just reactivate these nuclear reactors and nothing's going to happen. So, I mean, add insult to injury, watch something happen, and then they'll, you know, be like with their foot in their mouth. So on to other news. Tropical Storm Danny looks like it's going to be the first hurricane of the 2015 Atlantic hurricane season.
Oh.
And has intensified.
It's been a while since a hurricane hit down there.
Oh, yeah, it has been. And it's been quite a while, and it could reach the Leeward Islands early next week. According to forecasters, right now it's moving westward at about 12 miles an hour, and it has winds overnight increased from 45 to 50, which makes it a moderately strong tropical storm. The official forecast from the National Hurricane Center indicates that the tropical storm Danny could become the first hurricane, as I said, of the 2015 season on Thursday. And they're forecasting the winds to increase to 90 miles an hour on Saturday, which would make it a Category 1. By Sunday, it could be a Category 2, which has winds of 96 to 110. And from there on out, some of the models take it either south into the Caribbean toward the Virgin Islands, eventually near Cuba, or take it north, skirting Puerto Rico and along the northern coast of Hispaniola and Haiti, and then into the southeast Bahamas. It's something to keep in mind, the fact that by Monday it's just reaching the Leeward Islands. And so we have about 12 to 15 days to really monitor this. But it could actually be the first possible threat from a hurricane since Sandy affected the United States years ago. So it's definitely something to keep an eye on since Sandy in 2012. So on to other news. Storms could spread more contaminated heavy metals. And this is from a collapsed mine that occurred in a Colorado mine spill. What happened was there was contractors through the EPA. They accidentally released about 3 million gallons of toxic water, and it's flowed down the Animas River, depositing dangerous metals such as lead, arsenic, cadmium.
Yeah, and we talked about that last week where the EPA now says it's safe to swim in the water, and I think the mayor himself drank a glass of water. The governor, what was it?
I'm sure it was bottled water.
Well, he scooped it right out of there, and they said it was okay to drink. But yeah, that was a horrible, horrible, right by the Four Corners mistake in Colorado, and just everything is just destroyed now, and dumping chemicals in there once again, another spill. Also, there was an article, Ron. I don't know if you saw this one. I think I may have sent it to you. How the Navajo chased John McCain off Navajo land. It was
yes.
A pretty interesting video where John McCain went to go and meet with them, and the Navajo basically were drumming and singing, and when he came, they basically chased him off the land. They don't want him there. I'm sure people can figure out why. And also, there's another article that came out regarding Louis Pasteur about vaccines. We talk about vaccines a lot. I'm going to post this one up. And talk about Louis Pasteur, how he's a plagiarist, an imposter, and the truth about vaccines. Really interesting article. Pasteur, who was basically they coined pasteurization after him because he was the one who found out the process of how to get the harmful microbes out and keep food fresh. Well, what they're saying now is that pasteurization does not kill all supposedly harmful microbes, and it definitely does damage the food by destroying natural enzymes and nutrients in it. So interesting article on that front. Any other?
Hello?
Ryan, you there?
Yeah, you cut out for a second.
Okay. Any last stories for the Daily Download?
Yeah, sure. An article that just recently came out of the London Telegraph basically says that the doomsday clock for economic collapse is even closer to midnight. And this just shows that basically things have been ratcheting up. And then today, even as SRN News reported, that the stock market is down in the United States domestically. But now we're just 1 minute to midnight as central banks are totally losing control. Mm-hmm. And China currency devaluation signals an endgame. which basically leaving equity markets free to collapse under the weight of impossible expectations. When the banking crisis crippled markets 7 years ago, as we remember in the Great Recession, banks that said they were too big to fail were bailed out. That's right. That's been the case in other countries as well. We're not the only country that's been bailing out our currency.
Greece just had its third.
Exactly. Greece is doing it. A lot of currencies have been injecting false capital just by adding more ones and zeros digitally from our Federal Reserve as well as in Brazil. And that's why really over the weekend, last weekend, Brazil has had this uproarious clash with hundreds of thousands of protesters asking for the ousting of their current president over there. So time is really rapidly running out.
And I just want to cover one more article. This came out last night. Obama appoints first transgender White House staff member. I think that the Caitlyn Jenner phenomenon that's been sweeping the nation and people and news anchors walking off live air because they don't want to talk about the Kardashians. Neither do I. But this is something to take note on, that the White House now has hired a transgender person. And the person who they hired, Rafi Friedman Gerspin, a former policy advisor at the National Center for Transgender Equality, will serve as an outreach and recruitment director in the White House Office of Presidential Personnel. So with that, I think I'm going to go with our Game of Thrones person. We have a little drum roll rhyme. Game of Thrones person of the day. We're going to go with Caitlyn Jenner. Caitlyn Jenner is our Game of Thrones person today. Ryan Matthew Dernick, thank you so much for reporting the news and updates. Your live feed is on starseedradio.com. And also you could check bellweatherpost.com, where Ryan is posting up articles nonstop, 7 days a week, 24/7 almost, always taking care of the world today and what's going on in the news, and always taking care of it and posting it up. So thank you for that, Ryan.
And thank you, Jenna.
See you tomorrow. Enjoy your day. With that, we're going to go to our next guest, Mr. Phillip E. Collins. But first, to give you a little background on Phillip, he has quite a background. His original background starts over in Los Angeles on the West Coast. Mr. Phillip E. Collins brings a multidimensional background into being one of the co-founders of the Angel News Network and founder of the Modern Day Mystery School as a teacher, life coach, author, poet, filmmaker, and healing arts light ascension therapist, addressing the balancing of our emotional, mental, and physical bodies during the transformational times. Phillip's background also includes international commercial TV production skills with filmmaker George Lucas as a director of marketing at Industrial Light and Magic, and founder of Fairbanks Film Academy with film directors Ridley and Tony Scott. He has a wealth of knowledge in not just the 3D realm, but in the 5D realm, which is always why we love having him on the show, and his information is so powerful. With that, Phillip, thank you for coming on the air. How are you today?
I'm great. It's great to be back with you, Jonah.
Excellent.
You know, listening to that news update, I just wanted, I know we have some things we want to talk about on discernment and resonance today, but I'd like to respond to some of the things that was in the news blurb.
Yes, please.
Which really come from higher realms. When we're really looking at what's going on with the Northwest, let us remember that that is a residue of the Lemurian continent that broke off. And the activity that's happening in the Northwest now, with the activation, with the geoactivity there, that's correlating with the Madrid Fault in the middle of the continent, that's all a part of the breakoff that's in process again from ancient times. So I love to get the cause and effect when we get into the Gaia reports. I just wanted to add that piece of wisdom for those that resonate with it about what really is representing there along the West Coast, particularly the Northwest. These are all ancient Lemurian residues, land masses that are shifting and changing, and of course the whole continent sank, you know, 12 or 13,000 years ago. So the continents are moving. They were once all together in Pangaea. They separated. Now they are moving back together in oneness consciousness, which is affecting the economy, and I'll get into that in just a minute. So know that sure. That out-breath and in-breath of the continents is what's taking place. Also with the weather, let us remember that our emotions and thoughts stored in the atmosphere is what creates our weather. And this is the missing wisdom in humanity. So let's look at where a storm emanates from. Say it's from the west coast of Africa, it travels across the Atlantic and affects the east coast of the United States. Look at where these storms originate, what are the emotions and thoughts and activities there, and where do they hit and land, and begin to tie in the emotions and thoughts in those variables. moving on to the economic shifting, that has to do with the ascension process and moving from the deceit and the denial of this deceit within the false economy systems that have been created and how that is shifting and changing. And then finally, the last thing I just wanted to comment on for the news update, this whole transgender issue is a reveal of humanity to begin to truly understand what our gender is. It is not just male and female. We actually have six genders. And we're beginning to understand exactly what sexuality and the balance of masculine and feminine energies really are. So we take a messenger like Caitlyn and other many who preceded this individual. They're really teaching humanity it's more than what it seems. So I just wanted to respond to those things from the news blast and share that.
Yeah, thank you for that, Phillip. It's always good to have another perspective coming from the higher realms, which is what we try to do here on Starseed Radio. A lot of listeners may not be so tuned into the higher realms, but they're always, like you said, is a higher order of things going on, like Pangea coming back together. That's probably something most listeners don't even realize or think about. If you would, Phillip, I know you've come from a background working with George Lucas out in Los Angeles doing movies. You've really come from a very 3D background, if you will, in the movie industry, working with Cameron, with Avatar. If you could, just briefly, you know, talk about how it was working out there with Lucas and hanging out with these guys and then how it transponded to what you're doing today. Like, when was that switch? When was that awakening where you sort of left the movie world behind in the 3D realm? Because I know you're still working on a play with your new book. But when was that switch? When was that sudden awakening?
Well, I just would also respond, what we just did with the news was a macro-micro perspective. It's very important that we put the cause and effect of macro-micros together, and that's what we were just doing there. And also, I just want to mention my colleagues at the Angel News Network, or Jeff Fasino, who's a trans channel of many frequencies as well, and Joel Anastasi, who's I call him our spiritual energetic editor and journalist. Industrial Light Magic is up in Northern California. It's in the Marin County area in San Rafael. And as most people realize, what George Lucas has done recently is he sold a large portion of that enterprise to Disney. It was about a $4 million deal. But how I came together working with Lucasfilms and Industrial Light Magic was bringing that technology, that digital technology, and at the time it was brand new. The Lucas people had invented it. Now it's sort of common everywhere. But at the time, what they wanted to do was to enter into commercial communication, which was the second largest form of communication on the planet, and into documentaries and into industrials and music videos. And I married that together is how we came together, because I came out of the advertising industry working for Young & Rubicam and working for other commercial film production companies. So we married that digital technology with the commercial production world and introduced that ability. If you had enough time and money, we could create anything visually. And people like Jim Cameron was associated with the studio. And then you look at Avatar, you look at Star Wars, and you really realize the higher realm messages that these are really bringing out. I mean, I can remember as a young man myself seeing the world premiere of Star Wars, not knowing later I would be working with that enterprise, and how it thrilled everyone to realize there was something more than beyond this frequency, right?
And I've always said that, Phillip. I'm so happy to hear you say that. The Star Wars storyline, the Avatar storyline, those aren't just made-up stories that these guys create in their head. They actually come from truth, from our truths, which humanity has really forgotten about, and those are the secrets that have been hidden from humanity and lost. And Cameron and Lucas are sort of bringing down these truths and putting them in the film. How is your reaction to that over the years?
Well, they're telling it in fiction, and my reaction is I want to tell it in nonfiction. I mean, I've written a book called Coming Home to Lemuria and an Ascension Adventure Story, and it's about me going through my light body into the inner of civilization. So they realized that a lot of the truth, and Joseph Campbell influenced Lucas a lot, they really realized that these stories couldn't be told as true stories. They had to be told sort of as fables or myths or science fiction. But in our hearts as humanity, when we saw this, we knew there was a truth beyond that, more than what was being told on the screen. And so The wonderful thing is I think we're evolving as a species, really getting ready to really realize there's something as exciting as Avatar, Star Wars, happening right here, and are we advancing as a species enough to really accept that truth?
And I'm glad you said that, because I remember when Avatar first came out, Phillip, there was reports of people all over the planet that refused to leave the movie theater after the movie. There's even some people that committed suicide after the movie because it hit such a resonance in remembering the truth of who they were and how hard it is sometimes on planet Earth here. And people realize that, and that's why people sometimes commit suicide or do these acts where they just can't take it anymore, because it is a very active, dense reality that many of us are just not used to. So when Avatar came out, it struck such a memory in everyone's really DNA memory that's one of the reasons it was so impactful on so many people's lives. I remember just reading about it all over, these crazy stories, people refusing to move to the theater. So I'm glad that you mentioned that, because it is, it's in our memory, it's in our DNA.
Yeah, but for me, I wouldn't even contemplate the idea of suicide. For me, it was sort of a wonderful remembrance and excitement of now we can really tell the truth. We have the technology to show things and tell things in a way that can activate that failure memory within our DNA. So now it's a time to really, I think, really now tell the truth in even a more forthright way. And that's what we do at the Engineers Network. And we're looking at the tools in order to do that. And one of the things you and I wanted to talk about was, this gift of discernment and this gift of resonance within our spiritual growth, with our awakening. Because we realize, many of us, your audience, I'm sure, we understand that our planet and our species is involved in a shift like never before. It's a shift that happened with the past creation of golden ages like Lemuria, Atlantis, Egypt, or Mayan, or Aztec, or Hopi, or whatever. But now we realize this old paradigm. And then we talked about in the news brief of our governments, our religions, our corporations, our medical and educational systems, which attempt to control, but we can't control what we didn't create, so control is really illusion, but they attempt to control it, aren't meeting the needs of humanity anymore. They aren't meeting them. And so we're now beginning to wake up, and we're ready to commit to creating something new, creating new equality and harmony.
Now, Angel News Network, Phillip, you work with Joel and Jeff, so the three of you really bring together new information from the higher realms. We're going to take a commercial break in about 5 minutes. When we come back, you are actually going to channel live on the air. Can you give the listeners a background on the channeling, what people can expect, and where this information is coming from? How is their intro?
Yeah, we all have a soul plan. Within it, we choose, and then we're chosen to be messengers of these realms. And I would just like to say that whatever I have the ability to do, it's just a way showing for all of us to have the ability to eventually do that. I'm just working with colleagues that we are messengers and way showers and light workers within that. But what we are doing now is a natural ability for everyone.
And when you do a live channeling, when we come out after a commercial break, you are not conscious, correct?
Correct.
So the entity that will come through could be any entity at any time, or is it usually one select entity?
Sometimes I know ahead of time, and sometimes I don't. It has to do with the topic. With this, I think it's going to be definitely within the archangelic realm, either Michael or Gabriel, or it might be the council that represents all the archangelic forces. We'll see what arrives.
Excellent. So as we take the commercial break, Phillip will sort of go into his trance. When we get back, I'll make the announcement we're back on the show, and then Phillip will sort of go into trance live on the air, and then I will go ahead and ask a series of questions. And we talked about resonate. Phillip, what does resonate mean to you, resonance?
Well, resonance is how you feel about something, which comes from your heart space. It's an emotive feeling, an emotion. Your discernment is from your mental body. It's how you think about it. So what we want to combine are these internal gyro systems, these tools of resonance and discernment that allow you to know which step works best for you, because there's a lot of messages and teachings coming out there. So how do you know which one to trust? And what we have is this internal gyro system of our resonance, how we feel about it, and a discernment, how we think about it, to know which path to trust and surrender to.
Excellent, and thank you. I know that's how I've sort of distinguished my information, is reading through all these truths that I've awakened. It's how my body and how I resonate with the information that I have learned to accept it as truth, or if I accept it as not my truth, is how I have physical reactions sometimes, physical emotions. My hair stands up, my third eye opens up. These resonate signs, if you will, is how I discern different information nowadays as I learn to listen to my gut and the information that's coming through. So
let me ask you this. Do we have time for me to read a 30-second poem
sure.
that defines resonance?
Yes.
Okay, this is a poem that I wrote from a book that I wrote called Sacred Poetry and Mystical Messages. It's called An Internal Gyro System. We have a gifted gyro system in each of us. It is a must that we use it or we lose it and experience the consequence. The system is called resonance and discernment. It's how you feel and think about something to determine dissonance or not. It is a vibratory frequency of a person, place, or thing that will determine if you have a similar ring or frequency. The ability to use resonance and discernment is a key component in the moment of expanding your discernment, awareness, and fairness.
Wow, excellent. Perfect outro, if you will. And we're going to take a quick commercial break here, Phillip. And when we get back, we'll do a quick little intro once again, and then you can drop into trance, which probably takes about a minute or so. And then I'll open up with a series of questions, and we'll see what information comes through. And also, again, your website is angelnewsnetwork.com with Jeff and Joel. Shout out to Jeff and Joel. I'm sure they'll come on the show at one point as well. They also have interesting backgrounds. And you also have a new play you're working on through your new book, correct?
Well, we've taken Coming Home to Lemuria, which is about the inner of civilizations, and we being chosen as proxies to represent humanity and how that is affecting the shift that we're having now. So when you read the book, you become the proxy yourself. So we've adapted into a stage play, working out the characters and dialogue.
Excellent. All right, we're going to take a quick commercial break. We're joined by Phillip E. Collins. We'll be right back. Listen to Starseed Radio.
Oh, citizens of America. We are anonymous, and we have been observing as your country's leaders have lied to you and placed your freedom and your constitutional rights into jeopardy. We are very disappointed about this, and we have decided to take steps against what you are facing. The world is watching America. We are also watching. We are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.
All right, welcome back to the show. You're listening to Starseed Radio. Check out starseedradio.com for the latest news and updates. And if you haven't called for your free piece of elite shungite and your free energy information I want to send you, please call toll-free 888-400-2328. We're now joined by our very special guest, Phillip E. Collins. We were just talking before break, his background working with George Lucas in the movie industry, and now has moved his knowledge information into the higher realms by being an open channel to the masters and bringing messages to humanity to help guide us through this ascension time and process. Phillip, are you with us? Phillip, are you there? Maybe he went into trance. We'll just give him a minute. It takes about a minute for him to go into trance. And also, just so you know, listeners, you can check out angelnewsnetwork.com for some of Phillip's information, some of his books. He's written several books with Joel and also Jeff. Are you with us?
Greetings, beloved humans, being human. We are the Council of Archangelic Realms, known as CAR, C-A-R. We come to you at this important time of your ascension process of your beloved planet and humanity upon and within the surface of this planet that you have chosen to be a part of. You are all here not by accident. You are here by divine design, dear ones. The core issue is that humanity, mankind, if you will, has not yet understood or taken ownership of how you're creating what you are creating. Beloved humans, you create constantly, moment by moment, with your emotions and thoughts, expressed and unexpressed. You can think one thing and feel another, creating imbalance, not supporting self, other, or your beloved world. It is time, if you so choose, to become conscious of your emotions and thoughts creating actions. Words are the most powerful tool in the universe, and you support these words with your emotions powering them, dear ones. But your words and emotions do not always support one another. Only through becoming conscious of this can it change. Dear ones, the universe is a fax machine. It will send you back what it receives. A reconnection to higher realms can allow a loving, gentle way to learn with grace and ease. Through our support, it does not have to be painful or difficult, the way you have chosen to learn in the past and largely in the present, because you thought through your mental bodies, dear one, you could do it a better way. Your resistance to open yourself to higher realm support and easier ways is what creates the suffering and dissension and duality in your lives now. Today we wish to discuss the tools of discernment, how you think through your mental body, and your resonance, how you feel through your heart, and the tools that will allow you to create the life and world you say you want and you are destined to create. Prior to beginning this process of teaching, are there any questions at this time?
I just wanted to ask that if there is any special message that you could bring through regarding the resonance and what resonance is for humanity.
Resonance is how you feel. Your feelings are the connection to your divine essence, dear ones. It is essential that you learn to become in touch with your feelings, how you feel about something, how you express it. This will allow you to reduce or eliminate negative emotions by truly feeling them, allow them to be released and healed, if you will, in order to embrace your true divinity, your reason for being here. Without judgment, without shaming, without blaming, this is how you've chosen to learn what is not often through what is. Learning what is through what is not is how you are learning at present. But you can begin to make another shift if you so choose. Does that help you, dear one?
Yes, thank you.
So let us proceed, if we may, and then we can enter into a divine discussion, if you will, through the process. The most essential thing within your process of ascension, moving into a higher frequency of existence, and remembering that all of your past golden ages and the creation of your final golden age at this time have been the connection with we higher realms. We are of the realms to support you. It is our responsibility to support humanity. We are not alone. You have inner earth civilizations who advance to a higher frequency of existence. You have ascended masters who once walked the surface of your planet who have ascended into a higher form of existence. You have star realms that seeded your planet, 12 of them to be exact. You have galactic forces within your galaxy that are here to support you. All of these forces came together, dear ones, in the creation of what you call your planet. It is a great laboratory of learning to love, since love is the building block and the energetic frequency force of all creation. It is not just a human emotion. It is a building block of all that there is. So the first teaching we would like to share and open up to dialogue, if you would like, is being your message. Pay attention. If you are saying one thing and being another, pay attention if you are bringing in the higher realm truths and teachings which are available to you at this time. There are many individuals within your world now that are within the cloak of a public and private persona which are different. But their deceit and the denial of their deceit, whether they are in governments, religions, or corporations, will no longer hold fast. This is crumbling. You are seeing it in the distillation of your governments, your economies, your corporations. It is time for the few to no longer control the many. It is time to eliminate the herd mentality and understand your divine essence and stand within that empowerment. Being your message, learning your message, from the higher realms, activating it, bringing that out into the world, building communities of equality, harmony, and message is essential at this time. Are there any questions about the concept or the reality of being the message, dear one?
What are some tools that people can use to tune in their own message? Meditation, what are some ways that people individually can help them access their message for humanity?
Yes, meditation, quieting the mental body, surrendering to the void, surrendering to no thing, nothing. Within that, allowing all probability and possibilities within the unknowing. The most important aspect is to quiet the mental body, the human mental body, that thinks it knows it, that knows the better route. That has been the distillation of all past golden ages. It can be the distillation of what you're creating now without holding to the truth that these realms are here to support and love you and to guide you. This requires the mental body moving back into service to the knowing heart. Dear ones, within all of your hearts are stored within your DNA of all the lifetimes, the applied knowledge, thus wisdom, you have gleaned. The learning to think with the heart, reducing the function of the mental body, not eliminating it, is vital at this time. Does that help you, dear one?
Yes, thank you.
So being the message will be the foundation. And quieting yourself to learn what your message is, to know who you are, to know why you are here. And there are many tools, such as the Endeavor of the Angel News Network and many others that are here to support you. Through the foundation of who and why, you can build the what, the when, the where. Through knowing who and why, you can determine your needs. Many of you do not realize you have needs. From the truth of who you are and why you're here and the activation of your needs, you can set your boundaries, so that you maintain and sustain your soul plan. The channel that we're coming through now is to create an endeavor called Activate Your Soul Plan that gives you many higher realm tools to activate that plan if you need that support. The second area within our teaching today, dear ones, from the Council of Archangelic Realms from whence we come, Gabriel, Michael, Raphael, and Uriel, is being in a personal process. Dear ones, it is essential that you be involved in a deep examination of yourself through a process that supports your highest good, for the self is the reflection of the entire universe and creation, since you are the divine being having a human experience. You can do this personal process on your own individually or within groups. There are many metaphysical therapists and trained individuals to support this process. Use your resonance and discernment on who you select. Go with what feels right to you. Your advancement, your personal process, dear ones, is a process of inside out, not outside in. If someone is telling you to do this or to do that or take this or do that or is attempting to fix you, use your resonance and discernment whether you go forward with that. You will apply what resonates on your own timetable and throw the others out with a window. Use your own discernment and resonance. You are all on your own unique timetable of your awakening. Through knowing who you are and why you are here, you will awaken your talents and gifts that you all have, and you will bring that joyfully out in the process, your personal process. As long as you are within the frequency, the 3D frequency, you will be in a process, a personal process, dear ones, of growth and expansion. Do not try to escape it, but to be within it and to live it, dear ones. So in combination with being the message, being in a personal process is vital. Breath, sound, and motion will help that therapeutic process, but will not facilitate it totally on its own. Again, dear ones, it is a process of inside out. actually, every single thing that we are discussing at this time, you already know. This is simply, dear ones, an awakening. Is there any questions about being in a personal process?
What are some other ways that we can help others awaken to their personal process, or is this something we should not interfere with?
Honor the journey of each individual. Allow them through their resonance and discernment to come forward when they are ready. When the student is ready, dear one, the teachers will appear. It is not something that can be forced or coerced upon an individual. Allow them to come forward. Bring your programs, your endeavors out. Those who resonate and discern with joining it will come forward. You have been gifted with the Ethernet. You have been gifted with cyberspace, largely from the archangelic realm of Uriel, to allow your communication to be freer than it has ever been, although that system of communication is being largely corrupted at this time. So we ask you to be aware of that. Cyberspace was not invented by a human being, dear ones. It was gifted to you by we of higher realms to free you from those who have been controlling your communication in the past. They are largely trying to control the Ethernet at this time, which they cannot totally do. Remember, dear humans, you cannot control what you did not create. You did not create this planet. You did not create the Ethernet. You cannot control it. It is human folly to continue to do so. Does that help you, dear one?
Yes, thank you.
So being the message is your foundation. The being leading into the doingness, dear ones. So much of your world is coerced into doingness. You're running around through the stimulation of your nervous system, through the mental body, doing this, doing that, shopping here, buying this. Check in with yourself and see if you are being something. An emotion of happiness and joy would be a good indicator. And that joy and that bliss of beingness allows for doingness. This activity brings me joy. This activity brings me bliss. And allow that to be your determinant. Do not attempt to escape the human process, the personal process. This is what you committed to being and doing. The higher realms, particularly we of the archangelic realms, have put together many personal processes through the endeavor that we are discussing at this time, the Angel News Network. There's a process called Life Mastery that has been created by two or three divine souls through the archangelic realms of Michael, moving you from your believing mind, a belief system that can shift and change to your knowing heart. Moving from a belief, an erroneous belief system to the mental body into the knowing heart, dear ones. Know that truth if it resonates and discerns for you. Are there any further questions about being the message? Or being in a personal process? Pay attention to the word being, dear ones.
No, not at this time. No questions on that subject.
So let us move on. A third component that will assist you is knowing it is all your divine birthright. No matter what is happening within your personal lives or in your world, there is a divine process taking place that represents how you have chosen to learn. Through the ownership of how you have chosen to learn, you will eliminate or reduce victimhood. No one else is making anything happen except you, being supported by higher realms, whatever you choose to call us. Whether you believe we exist or not doesn't negate our existence. If someone else's name for these higher realms resonates, if you do not resonate with the terminology archangel or angel, then create another one. For the names that you have given us are simply a way for you to identify us. We move from a singular pronoun, me, to a plural pronoun of we, because we are a band of consciousness, moving from the me to the we. Your ability to grow and expand is a natural part of who you are. It's a natural part of why you came here, choosing to be human. You actually created a human contract, and you're in the process of activating that contract, which through the ascension process of your planet is expiring. Dear ones, your planet has decided to return to being a body of light. You all came from love and light. It is your destiny to return to it. So in effect, your planet, your beloved Mother Gaia, Earth, is becoming a star. Thus, everything upon and within, the body of that star will be of a light as well, or will not be here. For those of you who choose not to ascend into light, you will be given that opportunity through your freedom of choice and freedom of will to do that in another galaxy, in another solar system, on another planet, through your own freedom of choice and freedom of will. Dear ones, not every planet, not every solar system has that gift of a freedom of choice and will. Awakening and remembering your divinity is an essential part of this process. You are divinely expressing yourselves within each and every moment of the now. Look at the world around you, dear ones. Is it filled with we the people, for the people? It is your time, if you so choose, to demand and command your identity, creating communities of equality, harmony, and balance. That is your destiny. That is your self-empowerment through knowing why you're here, through knowing your needs, through expressing your boundaries. Are there any questions, dear ones, about your divine birthright?
I just had a question regarding people's choice of the upcoming ascension process. When you say that there are other worlds, does this refer to people not going within the light and ascending to another Earth somewhere, or is it ascending through the death process here on the planet and then reincarnating on another Earth?
It is both, dear ones. It has to do with the soul plan of the individual. You are in the process of a third, a third, a third within humanity. A third will be leaving the system, the 3D, if you will, and ascending through that process. A third will resist the change, and you see that within your governments and your corporations and to your religions to a certain degree. And they are a third who are awakening and understanding consciously the process. But there are other galaxies and solar systems and planets within the universe where individuals can take the time they need to ascend within their individuated soul plans. Does that help you, dear one?
Yes. So does this mean that there may be some upcoming changes with Mother Gaia, like certain cataclysms and things like that, that we should be paying attention to?
Your planet is constantly within a clearing and cleansing process. Some of these variables have to do with human activity that are exacerbating certain events. Some of them have to do with the divine soul plan of the planet herself, as the continents and the land masses expand and grow, in-breath, out-breath, receiving, giving. The planet breathes in through your seasons and out through your seasons. She also breathes through the movement of her continents. How you abuse her organs, her water, her oil, her gas, her air, her minerals, affects this process. She is a mightier force than humanity itself and will maintain and sustain herself through whatever necessary clearing and cleansing processes are to survive. An example that we might give is the advanced civilization of Atlantis, dear ones. They were far more advanced than any of you are at this particular time in your evolutionary path. They had received, and as a result of what they had received in higher realms, had created a technology that was capable of destroying the planet. When the higher realms realized that that was in force, they were destroyed themselves, rather than allowing them to destroy the planet itself. As a result of that, some of the wisdoms and technologies from that civilization prior to its demise went on to create such civilizations as early Egypt, early Greece, early Aztec, early Mayan, and others. The technologies were sent forward, reconnecting to the higher realms and giving humanity another chance, if you will, to evolve. But it is an interesting observation from we of the higher realms, moving from me to we, to observe humanity loves to get stuck on a hamster wheel, if you will, of repeating old patterns of the past that is largely taking place now. There are many residue Atlantean activities taking place on your planet at this time that also took place in ancient times. It is time, if you so choose, dear humans, to make another choice. To begin to understand the interconnectivity of you and all of creation and you and one another is why the relationship with self, being the message and being a personal process, is the foundation of all that we speak, since you are a macro-micro reflection of creation. That is your divinity itself, dear ones. Does that make sense? Are there any questions around this?
No, not at this time. We have just about 1 minute left. Is there any final message for us from the Councils of Light?
The final two things that we would like to end on is understanding that your spirituality and your awakening at times can get in the way, and to use your discernment and residence and not allow others to think they have a better way or that they're special as a result of being spiritual or having knowledge. The channel that we're coming through is simply a way shore, preparing all of you to become telepathically connected to all that there is. And finally, dear ones, remember, it's all about love. It's all about you being students within the love diversity of planet Earth and creating we consciousness communities of equality, harmony, and balance to support universal cosmic love in order to affect and create your final golden age of oneness on this beloved planet. So we ask you, dear ones, what do you choose?
And thank you for that. With that, you're listening to Star Seed Radio. That was Phillip E. Collins. He does not have an active memory, so I'll call him after the show. But thank you, everyone and listeners out there, for taking part in this amazing message. And we will be with you tomorrow on Star Seed Radio.
Outcry for people who want a better planet, and there are powers that be that let their people panic. Look at the Gulf of Japan, could they have really planned it? Heading for the iceberg like the Titanic.
Atlantic mystery, Atlantis right from history, the truth about the pyramids and ancient Mayan prophecy. Space Odyssey, look into the anomaly.